Now, if you have a low GPA, you need to watch this video because the things I'm about to tell you guys are literally going to optimize your chances of getting into medical school. And sometimes I say, like, you don't need to watch the whole video, but this is not one of those times. And I really recommend that you watch the entire video if you're serious about getting into medical school. Because I'm gonna be telling you guys a secret that I recently learned about from an admissions counselor that med schools don't really want undergrad students to know about. What's going on, YouTube? Welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new here, hit that subscribe button. Just do it right now. It's quick and it's free for you, and it helps me out. So let me get right into this video. Sorry for the semi-serious introduction, but this video really is make or break for some of you. The things I'm about to tell you guys are tips and tricks, even secrets that med schools don't really want us to know. And these tricks and these tips are gonna help a lot of you get into med school. So I recommend just watching the whole video. I'm gonna be talking about four or five different tips that if you guys implement, you will have the best chance of getting into medical school this year. And so let's get right into the video, guys. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Michael. I am in a Master's of Biomedical Science program here at a medical school that I probably shouldn't name. But basically, what this master's program does is help boost your science GPA and help you get into medical school. So that is actually one of the tips I'm going to be talking about a little bit later. But just to give you guys a little bit of a background story, I recently attended a med school fair where a ton of different medical school representatives and admissions committees came to my particular school, and we were able to talk with each of them and kind of pick their brains on what they are looking for their particular med school. And I learned a secret that probably none of you have heard of. And honestly, this secret kind of blew my mind because it's gonna help most of you, if not all of you, with a lower GPA, be able to get into medical school without having to do a master's, without having to do a post-bac, without having to retake classes. Well, if you have a C minus in a class, then you're probably gonna have to retake that. But I'm gonna talk about that a little bit later as well. And so the time you've all been waiting for, the secret that I learned was that some medical schools, not all, but some, will calculate your science GPA and I think your cumulative GPA as well. I'm not sure on that, so don't quote me on that. But for sure, your science GPA according to your last 60 hours of coursework. And so, guys, if you're a little bit lost right now, this is an absolute game changer for people with low GPAs. I don't believe these med schools post that information on their website. So I feel like the only way you're going to know how they're going to calculate your GPA is by emailing an admissions counselor from that particular school that you want to apply to. But just think about it, guys. If you had a terrible freshman and even sophomore year of undergrad, you can still get into a med school. Even if your science GPA currently is below a 3.0, if they only look at your last 60 hours of coursework, maybe you did excellent in your junior and senior year of college. And so maybe your science GPA isn't a 2.8 or a 2.5. Maybe it's actually a 3.3 because they're only going to look at the last 60 hours of coursework. And that has to do with them looking at trends. I'm sure you've all heard that med schools look at trends. And this is just one way of them doing that. And so I can't guarantee that you guys will get into medical school based on this fact that I recently learned, but it will definitely optimize your chances of getting into a med school this year. And that's what this channel is all about, is how to optimize our chances to getting into medical school. Because it is super difficult to get into med school. And if you can at least get an interview, that would be a win. Okay, and so now let me give you guys three tips on how to further optimize your chances of getting into medical school and literally how to optimize those last 60 course hours. And so the first tip is If you have a C minus in a science class, or really any class for that matter, you need to retake it. Because there's no med school out there that is going to accept a C minus as like a valid grade. If a med school receives your transcript and they see a C minus, they'll just automatically assume that you didn't take that class because it just doesn't count. And so like many of you are gonna have to do, I had to retake a few classes, one being organic chemistry. I know probably all of you absolutely hate organic chemistry because it is so weird and just so difficult to wrap around your mind. And so the first time I took organic chemistry, I got a C, and then organic chemistry 2, I got a C minus, pretty much because I didn't understand OChem 1. So I just went and retook both of them. I got A's in both of them the second time around. And I kind of attribute that to the professor who was top notch. The professor I took before was absolutely terrible. But I do think that I understood the material a lot better the second time around, which is probably a normal and good thing. And so that's tip number one. So tip number two would be apply to low tier medical schools. And so if you're watching this video, I assume it's because you have a lower GPA than normal. So I'm gonna recommend that you guys apply mostly to DO schools because DO schools tend to take students with a lower GPA and a lower MCAT score. And if you guys need to know which schools fall into which tier for DO schools, I made a video on this. I'll put the link down in the description below. And then also I'll attach the video to the end of this video. And so if you scroll to the very end of this video, you should see that video pop up. And so I mentioned that DO schools tend to take students with a lower MCAT and a lower science GPA, but you're not gonna see that reflected in their numbers on their websites, because they are only posting the GPA of the student from his or her last 60 hours of coursework. So while the student may have a science GPA of 2.5 or 2.8 or 3.0, the student's GPA during the last 60 hours of coursework is probably a little bit higher. So it's probably like a 3.1 or 3.3. And so when DO schools say they take students with a lower science GPA, they're not lying. They're just only showing you the numbers from that particular student's last 60 hours of coursework, which ultimately boosts the med school's average GPA numbers. So my last piece of advice for you guys, which is also tip number three, would be to consider doing a master's degree after your undergrad. And the reason I recommend doing a master's over post-bac is because, number one, you wanna do your master's at a medical school. And a lot of these medical schools will offer you direct admissions if you do well in their program. And so an example of this would be if you got a 3.75 in their master's program, they would automatically admit you into their next med school class. Another thing that these medical schools do if you're in their master's program is if you do well enough, usually like a 3.5, you're guaranteed an interview for their med school. And generally when you do a post-bac, you're just doing it at your undergrad institution, and you're generally just taking a lot of upper division courses that don't give you a certificate or degree of any sort. Whereas a master's, you're actually gonna get a degree in something other than what you got in your undergrad or your doctorate during med school. Another positive thing about doing a master's program at a medical school is that most of your professors and most of the faculty teach in the med school as well as in the master's program. So by the time you finish your program, you already know most of the faculty that will be teaching you in med school as well. So they'll know your name. The good thing for you is that you'll know how they teach and how they test. And a lot of med students that I talk to here at my school say that the students that were in the master's program last year are the ones that lead the class in med school now, because the classes are so similar that the master's students that are now in med school have a huge advantage and already know a lot of the material for your first year of med school. So the master's program not only helps you get into med school, but it helps you do extremely well in med school. And so guys, if you have any questions about master's programs, just drop that down in the comments below. I'll answer your questions. If you guys want me to make a specific video just on master's programs, I can do that as well. Just let me know and I can get that made for you guys. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. It didn't cover a lot of the generic stuff that you hear on a lot of other YouTube videos. The content I bring to you guys is unique. It's not generic at all, and it's gonna help you optimize your chances of getting into med school.